In our previous discussion, we discussed what is calorific value, various types of calorific value. We'll see here how to obtain GCV and NCV. Before starting this, let us recollect what is calorific value. Calorific value is defined as amount of heat liberated when a unit mass of a fuel is burned completely in excess of air, or a calorific value of a solid or liquid fuel can be determined using bomb calorimeter, whereas for gaseous fuel it can be determined using Boyle's calorimeter. Boyle's calorimeter is named after a scientist, Boyle. Our video syllabus does not contain determination of calorific value using Boyle's calorimeter of a gaseous fuel. It contains only determination of calorific value of solid or liquid fuel using bomb calorimeter. Let us discuss the construction and working. Bomb calorimeter consists of platinum or ceramic crucible in which known weight of solid or liquid fuel is taken. This crucible is mounted in a stainless steel vessel, in an airtight stainless steel vessel. This vessel is known as bomb. The stainless steel vessel is known as bomb. Bomb is equipped with oxygen valve because oxygen is must for combustion of any type of fuel. It is also equipped with electric ignition system. Why? Because the quantity of fuel is taken is very small. We cannot ignite using a matchbox or a lighter because it is airtight. Therefore, it is equipped with electric ignition system. This bomb equipped with electric ignition system, oxygen valve, is kept in a airtight copper vessel which is known as calorimeter. So what is calorimeter? Calorimeter is nothing but copper vessel. This copper vessel or calorimeter contains known weight of water, stirrer and thermometer in order to measure rise in temperature. This is construction. Let us discuss the working part. So here, before ignition of the fuel, initial temperature of water is taken using thermometer. The fuel present in the platinum or ceramic crucible is ignited using electric ignition system. The fuel is burnt. Energy in the form of heat is liberated. The liberated heat is absorbed by the surrounding water. Temperature is increased. Rise in temperature or final temperature is shown by thermometer, and rise in temperature is noted down. By knowing the weight of fuel taken in the platinum crucible, weight of water taken in calorimeter, rise in temperature, we can determine calorific value of a given fuel sample as follows. Mass of fuel sample, let us consider it to be mkg. Weight of water taken in calorimeter is W1 kg. Water equivalent of calorimeter, it means weight of calorimeter and other accessories, its weight is W2 kg. Total water equivalent of calorimeter is W1 plus W2 kg. Initial temperature is given by T1 degree Celsius. Final temperature is T2 degree Celsius. Rise in temperature is given by difference in initial and final temperature as nothing but T2 minus T1 degree Celsius. Now the question arises, why should we consider weight of water or water equivalent, that is weight of calorimeter and other accessories? So weight of water taken in calorimeter is very important. Why? Because the rise in temperature depends upon the weight of water taken in the calorimeter. For instance, if we take just 100 ml of water in one beaker and 1000 ml of water in one beaker, and if we heat water in two containers for 5 minutes in high intensity of flame, the beaker which contains 100 ml of water starts boiling, whereas the beaker which contains 1000 ml of water, the temperature will be 60 degrees Celsius. Therefore, weight of water is very, very important. Next, coming to weight of calorimeter and other accessories. So, as we know that what is calorimeter? Calorimeter is copper vessel, right? So, copper is, as you all know, it is a good conductor of heat. So, when heat is absorbed by water, the same thing will be absorbed by calorimeter also. Therefore, weight of calorimeter is also taken into consideration, right? So, we're going to take W1, weight of water in calorimeter, and water equivalent W2 to calculate the calorific value. Let us see how to calculate calorific value of given fuel sample. So, amount of heat liberated by mkg of fuel is equal to amount of heat absorbed by water and other accessories. That is, amount of heat is represented by Q, that is Q into M equals, so amount of heat absorbed by water, it can be measured by difference in temperature. Other accessories is nothing but W1 plus W2. Right. Therefore, Q equals, we're going to push this M to the denominator. Its amount of heat liberated by mkg of fuel equals T2 minus T1 into W1 plus W2 by M. This is in calories per gram, but we want calories per gram is in CGS unit. In order to convert this into SI units, you're going to multiply it by 4.187. Therefore, heat liberated is nothing but GCV or gross calorific value is given by T2 minus T1 into W1 plus W2 into 4.187 divided by M kilojoules per kg. Next, NCV. What do you mean by NCV? Net calorific value. Net calorific value is nothing but amount of heat liberated when a unit mass of fuel is completely burned in excess of air or oxygen and the products of combustion are let off into the atmosphere. So, what are the products of combustion? As we have discussed, it is carbon dioxide and water. In GCV, we are considering the heat liberated by water. In NCV, we are not going to consider. Since already we have calculated GCV, in GCV, if you are going to remove the latent heat, you are going to obtain NCV. Therefore, NCV equals GCV minus latent heat of steam or latent heat of condensation is given by NCV equals GCV minus 0.09 into percentage of hydrogen into 587 into 4.187 kilojoule per kg. As I told you earlier, 587 is nothing but amount of heat liberated when 1 gram of water vapor is cooled to water liquid. 587 calories of heat is liberated. In order to convert that calories into SI unit, we're going to multiply it by 4.187. So, how do you obtain water? By amount of hydrogen present in the fuel. As we have discussed the definition of fuel, that is, it contains carbon and hydrogen as its main constituents, right? So, hydrogen present will get converted into water. So, the water is mainly obtained by percentage of hydrogen. Therefore, going to consider percentage of hydrogen also in order to calculate latent heat of steam or condensation. So, in my earlier discussion, I told you 0.09 is as a constant. So, now let us see how we get this 0.09. If a sample contains 2 grams of hydrogen, you obtain 18 grams of water. So, how do you get 18? 18 is the molecular weight of water. So, now for instance, 1 gram of hydrogen gives how many grams of water? Just cross multiply. 1 into 18 divided by 2, you get 9 grams of water. Now, if you convert this into percentage, how do you convert into percentage? Divide by 100. So, when you divide 9 by 100, how much you get? 0.09. So, this 0.09, how you obtain as? By that method. Therefore, 0.09, I have told you how you got amount of hydrogen present in the fuel. So, 587 is when 1 gram of water is condensed to water liquid. 4.187 is the conversion factor.
Please like and share this video and do subscribe to the Video Resource YouTube channel.